This brief demo will provide you a quick tour of EG Innovation's Converged Application and Infrastructure Performance Monitoring for .NET environments. Since Microsoft's .NET is one of the most popular technologies for powering business-critical digital services, it's critical to monitor the performance of the .NET stack. EG Enterprise is a full-stack APM solution that provides total performance visibility, from .NET code and SQL statements to CLRs, IIS, and other supporting .NET ecosystem components such as storage, network, virtualization, and the cloud. Let's start with the digital user experience. EG Enterprise has built-in real user monitoring. Here's an example of a user experience page showing real user information. The page shows us real user traffic, including page views per minute, device distribution, unique session count, an AppDex score, page load time, and whether there were any JavaScript errors. The embedded analytics shows us where issues are originating, in this case, page load time. Clicking the color-coded metric takes us to a list of slow transactions, and by clicking the detailed diagnosis icon, we can see a visual representation of the front end. This shows us everything that's going on in the front end for this transaction. Information about the user, the browser, network connect time, backend server time, and content download. In this case, the problem's originating in the backend server time. When front-end triage tells us the issues in the backend, we can immediately see the topology of the monitored digital service. The topology shows a visual representation of the end-to-end dependencies, and the embedded analytics clearly identifies the tier that's the source of a performance issue by color-coding the component, in this case, an IIS server. Clicking the component takes us to a layer model for the IIS server and shows us the top-to-bottom dependencies for this component. It's telling us that the .NET business transactions test for list products has an issue. The metrics window is telling us we have high response time. Clicking the detailed diagnosis icon brings us to a list of transactions. From the transaction snapshots list, all we have to do is click on a transaction to open its trace. The trace of the transaction will automatically tell us which tier of the transaction is slow and indicate whether it is slow, stalled, or having errors. The analytics will automatically isolate slowness due to application errors, slow database queries, or remote and third-party calls. All that's required is clicking on an icon to get details about business transaction performance issues. In this case, a .NET ASP call. And in this case, a database query. Business transaction and application performance issues are automatically isolated by the monitor. But of course, issues with performance of .NET environments won't be limited to applications. Customers need in-depth visibility into .NET ecosystem dependencies. And this includes information about IIS sites, application pools and worker processes. For example, understanding the status of all application pools configured on an IIS web server, worker process measures, and thread measures. The monitor also looks at the HTTP error log and reports errors, and provides detailed diagnostics that can shed more light on connection timeouts and orphan requests. And of course, we monitor the performance of the CLR as well. This includes things like heap usage, garbage collection, class loading, thread contentions, and runtime checks. All are monitored in real time, and anomalies are captured on the fly. Finally, .NET applications can be impacted by non-Microsoft components or cloud services as well. For example, an Oracle database could be experiencing issues, and the monitor will automatically discover dependencies. In this case, the Oracle database is impacted by issues within a virtual environment, which could be a public or private cloud. We can immediately drill down and see that the issue is with physical disk space on an ESX host. Even if part of the .NET ecosystem were hosted in the cloud, we could use the same embedded analytics and the same layered user interface to isolate issues, including critical Azure services such as virtual machines, Azure web apps, critical services such as data services, and resource groups. All of these ecosystem components need to be monitored in real time and in the context of the relevant digital business service.